Hey, what's up guys? So this is a two-part video after my unboxing and review of the Huawei Y7P, which I made a video about, and you can find that video linked in the description of this video. That being said, in this one we're going to be talking about the Huawei App Gallery. Just like Apple has the App Store and Google has the Play Store, well, we have the Huawei App Gallery for Huawei. So why is this? What does the Huawei App Gallery have to offer? In this video, I'll talk about that and more, and as always, I'll have my timestamps in the description below so you can skip ahead to different sections of this video that you need quick information about. Without further ado, let's get to the video. So to get started and taking sort of a history lesson, in May of 2019, the US government placed Huawei on its entity list. This basically means that all US companies, including Google, stopped from collaborating with Huawei. In summary, Google cannot work with Huawei on a new device model or provide any of their apps like Gmail, Maps, YouTube, the Play Store, and others for download or even preload on the new Huawei devices. So you're probably asking, is it worth it to buy a new Huawei device, especially if I lose access to those things? I'm not here to tell you yes or no. However, I want to look at what Huawei is actually doing about this situation. And for people who are actually interested in the value that the brand has to offer in their smartphones and also a workaround on the service, this video is for you. There is a solution. Looking at many Android devices that we're used to today, they usually come with Google Mobile Services or GMS, which is a suite of apps I mentioned earlier, YouTube, Gmail, Maps, Play Store, and the likes. And Huawei's solution is, as you guessed it, HMS, which is Huawei Mobile Services. For a quick overview, Huawei Mobile Services or HMS has the App Gallery, while GMS has Play Store. We have Huawei Cloud, which has 50 gigs of storage, and Google Drive, which has 15 gigs of storage. As a substitute for Gmail, we have the Huawei Mail, and of course, as a substitute for Chrome, there's the Huawei browser. There are more apps and more substitutes that aren't necessarily, you know, made by Huawei. Here Maps, for instance, but that's a later discussion. They have their own proprietary health app, which connects seamlessly to your Huawei smartwatch. You know, I had to mention that. I made a video about this Huawei smartwatch too, which is actually a very interesting piece of tech. I'll leave a link below for, you know, to watch the review on this watch or in the card up above. So you're probably asking, okay, Fisayo, I got the new Huawei device. What's the first thing I should do? One thing I liked that Huawei gave users right out of the gate was Phone Clone, an app that comes with your device. And the way it works is that you install it on your older device, which you want to migrate from and you want to leave, and it instantly sends or clones the data onto your Huawei device. It works really well. It helped me move large files across my devices to my Huawei device so I wouldn't lose anything. What if you didn't have any older device, or this was your first smartphone for some reason? Well, another method you can use, and this works for those who have even migrated, you know, and they want new data on their phone. If you want very popular apps, many apps like TikTok and Snapchat are already on the Huawei App Gallery itself, which is, again, for lack of a better word, like Play Store for Huawei devices. Back to popular apps now. For WhatsApp, when you search for it, it's linked in the App Gallery. It does link straight to the WhatsApp website itself from the App Gallery, and you straight up just download it there. How about Facebook? Similarly, you get to the direct Facebook Android download page, and you just download the APK or Android package kit file, the app file itself. One other thing I also want to mention is YouTube. Of course, you won't be able to get the YouTube app to work, and for that you need to use the browser or Opera Mini, which is a secure browser that actually saves data as well when you watch YouTube. Another thing to note is that Gmail works on the official Huawei Mail app, so there's nothing to lose. And you know, I saw a substitute for Google Maps, here Maps maybe, and you can even download your maps by their country, which I thought was cool. I'll be testing it out as well. I was able to get Instagram from my transfer via Phone Clone. However, it's not available on the Huawei App Gallery for some reason, even when Instagram is a Facebook product, and that is linked. You can also download the APK file itself. I'll leave links in the description for trusted third-party sources to download apps from. This also applies to Facebook Messenger as well. For many apps you may want and not get on the App Gallery directly, you can get it via another app called APK Pure, which is one of the third-party apps I mentioned. I've actually been using this app before, and Huawei actually scans each app before it installs them, which is an extra security measure. However, don't just download any third-party app downloader, because they can download malware onto your phone and use it to access your own private data. I was able to even download Call of Duty and PUBG again via APK Pure, which is one of the third-party apps I recommend. And even as far as was default straight out of the Huawei App Gallery. So there's pretty much nothing lost except for a few extra steps taken, which I've detailed in this video. And of course, if you do have any questions, don't hesitate to drop a comment below. I'll do my best to reply to every single one of your comments. Some interesting stats I saw was that 1.5 million developers have signed up to the Huawei App Gallery, and they now have over 60,000 apps now connected to the Huawei mobile services. For app developers, the Huawei App Gallery has created incentives to publish their apps on the Huawei App Gallery, you know, by offering 85% of revenue. And some educational apps will even earn up to 100% of revenue compared to 70% on the Google Play Store. This is a huge deal, and I'm looking to see how this goes, although it's temporary. If you've had a Huawei device, you may have seen the App Gallery alongside Play Store. Now is the time to actually see how much value is inherent here, and I really can't wait to see how well this does. If you like this video, you found this video valuable, please give it a thumbs up, and also do subscribe and click the bell icon beside the subscribe button if you'd love to see any of my new videos first. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys in the very next one.